Hello and welcome to Bapstar Arcade, and today we're going to be having a look at the A500 Mini. Now this comes with 25 games pre-installed, so we're going to be having a look at this, bit of an unboxing, having a look at what you get, updating the firmware, and also hacking the system and getting what your games are. So stick with me, and I'll see you in a bit. So as you can see, the A500 Mini comes with 25 games pre-installed. We've got Another World, Zool, Worms, Pinball Dreams. We've got Simon the Sorcerer, the Sentinel, Cadaver, Speedball 2. We've also got Dragon's Breath, Alien Breed, Sun Car Racer, Battle Chess, F-16 Combat Pilot. We've got Alien Breed 3D. Kickoff 2, Paradroid 90, Tetris, Lost Patrol, Arcade Pool, Project X, Supercars 2, Chaos Engine, California Games, Quack, and All Terrain Racing. Right, so there it is, the A500 Mini. So we've got three USBs, HDMI, and a USB-C. We've also got classic tank mouse, plug that into one of the USB slots. This is obviously a new mouse, so there's no trackball like the original, and we've got two micro switched buttons there. To give you an idea of the size of the original Amiga mouse, got one here, so as you can see, size comparison. And obviously we've got here a laser mouse over a ball mouse. So also in the package we have a joypad rather than a joystick, and this is very similar to the one that you had with the CD32 machine. I'll just plug this into another USB slot, and that gives us one spare one, which I imagine is for updating. What else have we got? So we've got a USB-C and USB cable. We'll plug the USB-C into the Amiga, and the other end we need to find a suitable power supply, which I'm guessing will run off an old mobile phone adapter. Got to find one. And then we have the HDMI cable. Now we should have a spare one already connected up to TV, so I'm just going to find one of those connected up. Right, plug the HDMI into the back of the system. Ready. So looking at the manual, we need an 5 volt 1 amp power adapter with a USB A port. So let's see what I can find. Well, I found this old HTC phone adapter, and that is 5 volt, 1 amp. So that should power the little beast up. So interestingly enough, I didn't get a picture from using a HDMI cable that I'd already got plugged in, which is odd. So I've plugged in the cable that you get with the machine and it's all working. So we've got a red power indicator, so we know we've got power to it, and now we're presented with the setup screen. Right, so let's run through the setup. Doesn't look like the mouse is working yet. The pad working okay. So select English, B for next. So we've got the option for 50 hertz or 60 hertz. We're going to go for 50 hertz for now, I think. You can run a television test. So let's run the test and see what we get. There we go. Nice menu system. Menu for options. So we've got some display options there. Fixed, moderate zoom or screen fit. We can add a CRT effect. Interesting to see what that looks like. Enable image smoothing. System options, we've got the mouse sensitivity, volume controls, power LED, mimic Amiga behavior, switches the LED from always on to normal Amiga. I'm going to set that to the normal Amiga behavior. Language we've already accepted. Advanced options, we've got television settings. So we've got your 50 and 60 hertz options there again. Use screen edges. Enable this option if your television can display a full 720p image without cropping. Well, this TV can, so we can leave that as it is. System information. So this is the 101 build, Manhattan Strange, whatever that is. We've got some legal jargon as always, and we also have a factory reset option. Shut down device. Okay, we don't need to do that. Back to the main menu. Right, let's test the game out. So what we got? Got some absolute classic games on here, but not all my favourites. So let's go for Project X. Which seems to be running nice and smooth.
Destroy waves for power ups. Select that into a bonus button.
There's a slight
select now for
input delay. Be interesting to see how this runs in 60 hertz, which we'll try in a bit. Personally, I'm not a fan of playing Amiga games on a pad. I prefer a joystick. Just don't feel as though I've got enough accurate control. But to be honest, this pad is really nice. I just don't think it's for me.
Select now for laser beam. Power up.
So pressing home takes us straight back to home. Now let's have a look at the options and see what we can alter. So we'll have a look at the CRT effect, and we will also, where was it, enable 60 hertz, give that a blast. On the television test, yeah, 720p 60 hertz, no problem at all. Watch accept. Just look straight back into the game. We're missing the top.
Laser beam.
Nice and smooth and responsive, though. So let's have another look at the other menu options. Ah, so in game, pressing menu brings up a keyboard. So we want menu, and what did we want to mess with? Display options. So it's set to screen fit. Let's try fixed size. See what that does. Right, okay. So now we've got the full image. I thought it would accommodate the full screen though. So we've got moderate zoom. I'd have thought screen fit would have worked, to be honest. So we'll look out. No, I'm missing the top and bottom. I don't know if that's anything to do with my TV settings. I don't think it is, because that looks full screen. No, nothing in there. Let's try the slight rating woeful. Let's try the moderate zoom option. So
destroy waves for power up.
Because at the end of the day, this machine was, the original Amiga was designed to be played on a monitor or a CRT. There weren't any widescreen TVs back then.
Select now for pressure. Approaching asteroid level. Select credits for bonus weapons. Select now for stealth.
But yeah, I'm really impressed with that. Let's just try one more game. Okay, so if we press up on the D-pad, we get help, what the majority of the buttons do. Press down. We've got our little floppy images for saved games. That's pretty cool. I like that. Favourite your games. Give them a star rating. Let's try another world. Absolute classic game. Still one of the best openings to a game. Let's try Speedball 2. There we go. So now let's have a look at upgrading the firmware. So step one is get yourself USB stick and we need to format this to FAT32. Right, so we make sure FAT32 is selected, and quick format, rename your driver if you need to. There we go, that's formatted. So head over to retrogames.biz and we're on the firmware page. Now, they recommend that you don't use a USB stick any larger than 32 gig. Also, they recommend you unplugging your mouse before updating the firmware. And there's quite a few extra features added in version 1.1.1. Adds ADF floppy file support, playlist support, hot crop, keyboard control of the user interface, virtual keyboard to be assessed at all times, controllers to be physically swapped during play, swaps the joystick, the C64 joystick, fire buttons, configures Competition Pro SL6603 TWT joystick fire buttons. Now, I think this is the joystick that you get with the C64 Mini, which we will also try. We've also got fixes the virtual keyboard cursor right button, save game issues are fixed, emulator GUI is also says access, so there's been a fix on that also, and fixes speed reduction in some circumstances. So we'll go ahead and download the latest update. So once that's downloaded, we can copy the file straight into USB drive. Don't put it in a folder, just put it straight into the root of the drive, and that's that step complete. So now we've got our firmware on our USB stick, we'll boot the A500 mini back up. And then start up, which we didn't see last time. So as recommended, we will disconnect the mouse and plug in our USB, and now we need to go to options, which is menu on the pad, then we need to go down to advanced options, and then we need to go to system information. It's found the new firmware. Do we want to apply the update? Well, we do. And while that's updating, we don't touch anything. And that should have worked. So we'll unplug the flash drive, re-plug in the mouse, and if we want to check, we'll go to options, advanced options, system information, and we can see there we've got the latest build, 1.1.1. So it doesn't look like we've got any immediate option changes. Does feel a little bit snappier, I think. The update hasn't given us any extra games. So let's load up Alien Breed. Such a good game. So yeah, that's running lovely. So that's the firmware update process. Okay, so what I want to try now is the Commodore 64 mini joystick that you get, which is very similar to the Competition Pro. I wouldn't say it was as tough as the Competition Pro. In fact, I'd be a little bit worried with this point. Part of the joystick here doesn't seem tough, but we'll give it a go. So we'll unplug the pad and see if the joystick works correctly. I see no reason why it shouldn't. Got no movement. I'll reset the A500. Ah, there we go. The joystick seems to be working now. So we go on Supercars 2. Yeah, I certainly like the feel better with a joystick, but truth be told, C64 mini joystick isn't that fantastic anyway. Good to see if there was an adapter so I could use a regular Kempson joystick or 9-pin joystick that the Amiga used. This game's still good fun though. Yeah, so there we go. The A500 Mini. Firmware updates was fairly straightforward. C64 Mini joystick works okay. So now, on to the hacking stage so you can get some more games on there. So we've got our A500 Mini and we want to add extra games. So we can either do it the official way, or there's also a brand new game selector menu system. So the official way is to go to the official website for the Amiga Mini, and on there we need to copy the WHD load file or files onto a USB stick, formatting FAT32. And there's also some bonus games on that website as well, which I will show you now. And then the other way of loading lots of games onto your Amiga Mini is by using the software Amiga Game Selector 2.2. So I'll show you how to get that up and running also. Okay, so from the A500 Mini support page, if we click on installing the A500 WHD load package, and that's the file there that we need to download. So if we download that and then copy that into your USB stick. So all we need to do is copy the file we've just downloaded onto the USB stick. So now we've got WHD load. It says bonus games, there's actually one game. Well, so we've got our USB stick, using a different one this time. Plug that into the Amiga Mini. The USB stick icon appears. Press A. Go to the games folder that we've downloaded and created. Select the game that is on there, and it's in an LHA format, as though it's on a hard drive. Select it, and then home to start the game on the pad. So this loads up the familiar desktop. So this is the Amiga Game Selector version 2.2. And there's been quite a few different updates for this. Extra game additions as well. VHD load updates. So once we're over at the download page, you've got a selection of links here to download the file. Now this is quite a big file, it's 11 gig, So depending on how good your internet is, will depend on which link is best for you. Torrent is probably the best option. In my case, I have used this HTTP link. Right, so we've copied the enormous 11 gig file across onto our USB stick. This is what the file structure should look like. So one thing we do need to do before we insert the USB drive into the A500 Mini is from the A500 folder, go into Save Data, Quick Starts. It'll show you all Quick Start files there. You just need to copy those to the AGS folder under Shared Quick Starts. You should be done. So let's put this into the Amiga Mini and give it a try.
Right, let's give it a go. So we'll select the USB drive again, go to AGS, Start AGS, Home to Start, Amiga Game Selector. There we go. Emulators, extra games, games all organised into different categories. Demos, got absolutely loads of stuff on here. Disc magazines, filters, game manuals, lots of options. Even a pick me a random game. So let's go games by system. So we could go for CD32, CDTV, Xenon 2.
Welcome to Xenon 2 by the Bitmap Brothers.
The A500 Mini, even better when you put on the Amiga Game Selector. So that's it for another video. Don't forget to like, subscribe and share. Thank you very much for your support. I'll see you in the next video. Ta-ra!